Hi everyone. So today we are going to have this Mental Health Awareness Month activities for students, or the different samples of activities that we can give to our students during this Mental Health Awareness Month. So we all know that we are having this National Mental Health Week this October 10 up to 14, and for the whole month of October, actually, we can give different mental health awareness activities to our students, or we can also give this to our students every time we conduct mental health related activities. Okay, so the first one, of course, is we can provide an educational mental health workshop. So this is the most conventional way or method that we can use. So we can organize this annually. So wherein you can set up a place for everyone to gather. So you can hire professionals, you can hire psychologists, psychiatrists, or guidance counselors, registered guidance counselors, to provide wellness talks or seminars to your students. So you can have this to your students. This will benefit your students greatly. So this month, you can hold this session activity, mga stress relieving activity session, mga workshops on stress reduction, stress management, mga wellness activity, so that they can, our students can reframe their thoughts, they can enhance their mental health. Okay, so this is one of the conventional ways that we can adapt, okay, provide a mental educational mental health workshop to your students. And likewise, we can also have this mental health awareness contest, wherein our students will be able to showcase their talents, their skills, and at the same time ma-enjoy pa ito ng mga bata ng ibang mga students, kasi will be able to witness this fun activity, So, number one, pwede kayong gumawa ng itong slogan writing contest na may theme about mental health. Same thing with essay writing. So, pwede nyo itong gawin isang araw. So, mag-assign lang tayo ng iba't ibang committee na mag-facilitate ng mga activity ito. So, we're able to do this last month during the Suicide Awareness Month. So, we conduct this slogan writing contest, essay writing contest, and poster making contest. And meron pang isa na pwede tayong idagdag, itong photography contest. So, another one that is very interesting, and I know na may enjoy ng mga students ninyo na panoorin, is itong spoken poetry na may theme about mental health. How are they going to take care of their mental health? And you can also have this mga short films on mental health, mga film viewing activities. Okay? And another one is you can also have this Zumba. Okay? Zumba for mental health. This is actually great for the mental health of everyone, because here, our students will be able to meet new friends, their schoolmates, and definitely this activity, itong mga physical activities na to, can definitely improve their overall well-being. So at least ma-reduce yung feeling of loneliness nila and isolation in case man nakakaramdam sila nito, because of the combination of dance, music, and exercise. So madi-distress sila, and they can it can also relieve anxiety. Okay? So Zumba, magpa-Zumba kayo this Mental Health Month. Another thing, another activity that we can give is itong fun run. Okay, maganda rin ito. Run for a cause. Okay, so pwedeng mag-register sila, and yung fund na makukuha ninyo, you will donate it, or you will have this mga activities na finance ninyo related to mental health. So maganda din itong activity ito, itong fun run, runners for mental health awareness. Okay, so Another one is you can also have this mini concert, especially kung meron kayong mga students na very talented. And I know marami tayong mga students na hindi lang natatap ang mga talents. So you can have this. And ang theme ninyo is on mental health. And isa pa sa mga very simple lang na pwede natin gawin is itong mental health booth. Okay? So pwede kayong maglagay ng booth sa school ninyo na kung saan nakalagay doon yung mga informative reading materials, mga reading materials on mental health. Maglagay kayo din ng parang pwede din ito maging peer booth ninyo. Okay, somebody na gustong pumunta doon will talk to a counselor, for example, ano, or they can give their comments. So, bahala po kayo sa pakulong gagawin ninyo. But this is a fun activity also that we can do during this Mental Health Awareness Month, itong mental health booth. Okay, so depende sa inyo kung anong pwede nyo ilagay. Pwede kayo maglagay ng mga different quizzes dyan, mga personality, fun personality test, quiz, or mga reading materials on mental health. Maglagay kayo ng mga posters. Okay. And likewise, you can also create an interactive bulletin board in your school. So actually, pwede itong gawin ng mga teachers sa loob ng kanilang classroom, that you can have this mental health interactive bulletin board. So in this particular activity, you know, they will be able to to unleash their creativity. And at the same time, very informative yung ilalagay natin. Ma-remind sila that we really have to take care of our mental health. So, pwede din na may mga box tayo malapit dyan sa bulletin board na yan. Since it is called interactive bulletin board, so they can post their questions, they can write their thoughts on the board. So, pwede din naman na maglagay sila ng mga questions, ano, including what made you smile today, okay? And they are going to pin their answers on that board. And what's your favorite activity to show off? What's your favorite activity? What activity do you enjoy most? So, iba-ibang questions. It depends upon you. Okay? So, maganda din itong mental health bulletin, interactive bulletin board. Okay? And also, na-mention ko na din kanina, you can have this film screening or movie analysis. So, marami actually mga movies about mental health illnesses, ano? So, pwedeng, depende rin sa movie, ano? We have to consider also the age of our learners. So, pwede tayong mag-research sa internet kung ano yung iba't ibang movies na pwede nating panoorin. So, isa sa mga very common na movie na pwede nating panood sa mga bata, wala sa mga kids, yung Inside Out. So, about their emotions. Meron din tayo yung What's Eating Gilbert Grape. Yung movie ni Leonardo DiCaprio. Okay? So, meron din tayong, actually marami. Depende talaga sa age ng bibigyan natin itong movie analysis or film screening. Okay? And another, we can also have this. This is also very important, and I really suggest that na magkaroon tayo nito, itong peer support group in our school. So, it's up to you what you're going to call the group, ano? But it's high time for you to launch already your peer support group this Mental Health Awareness Month. So, syempre, you need to train your peer facilitators, yung mga students na magiging member nitong peer support group. So that para mas ma-promote pa rin natin yung mental health among the youth. Kasi alam naman natin na yung mga bata, mas gusto talaga nila, yung mga estudyante natin, mas gusto nilang lumalapit sa mga kaklase nila, sa mga friends nila. So better yet, diba, mas ma-educate natin itong mga peers natin, ano, itong mga estudyante natin na kung anong gagawin nila in case man may lumapit sa kanila at humingi ng advice. Okay? So, napakaganda nito dahil the youth, ano, itong mga peers natin, itong mga students natin can actually actively promote and encourage ano everyone to be part of the support group. Dahil nga, ka-close nila, yung ka-classmates din naman nila. Okay? So, pwede tayo mag-create ng mga mechanisms then for youth-led peer support groups. Okay? And syempre, this should be managed by a teacher or a guidance counselor. Okay? So, actually, marami pang iba. Like, sa classroom, marami tayong pwedeng ibigay. Pwede tayong magbigay ng mga mental health quiz or self-care check-up. Okay? Pwede tayong magbigay ng mga call, mga drawing activities. Okay? Yung mga wherein the students can mindfully color and draw. They can also have this mga fun games. Maganda rin ito na maging activity natin during this Mental Health Awareness Month. Mga board games. Okay, so pwede din ng mga outdoor activities, okay? So, we also have this safe deposit box. Maganda din ito. Ginagawa ito ng mga teachers natin na may nakalagay ng mga suggestion box na kung saan students can drop a note about their own or fellow students' mental health. So, ano ba yung mga pwede nilang ma-suggest for them to improve their mental health? And meron din tayo mga activity like mood tracker, okay, itong wellness exchange gift, maganda din ito, i-try natin one of these days during this month of October, na hindi lang pala pang Christmas ang exchange gift, pwede din palang ibigay natin ito during this Mental Health Awareness Month. Anything na gusto nilang ibigay that will remind how valuable the person is, okay, so you can let the students pick a name of their classmate and then sila mag-iisip kung ano yung magandang iregalo nila para sa taong to, para ma-remind itong taong to that they really have to take care of their own mental health. And isa pa sa mga very common is itong mga post-its, ano, wherein meron tayong isang board, so ilalagay nila doon yung mga nararamdaman nila, ano ba yung mga emotions nila, ano yung mga gusto nilang sabihin. So para itong free wall, freedom wall. So yan lang, ano, actually marami pang iba. So you may comment down below kung meron pa kayong mga suggestions na mga mental health activity para matulungan natin ang bawat isa. Well, actually marami kasing nagtatanong kung ano ang mga mental health activity na pwede natin ibigay sa mga students natin. At yung mga na-mention ko, these are only some of the activities na sa tingin ko ay realistic, ano? Kaya nating magawa, kayang makandak sa school setting. Okay, so if you have any question, please do not hesitate to na mag-message po sa atin dyan sa comment box or sa ating Facebook page na Your Guidance Counselor. Okay, please do not forget also to subscribe to our channel. So I just hope na nakakatulong po itong channel na ito sa inyo. So that's all. If you have any questions, so please feel free to message me in my Facebook page because nire-replyan ko naman po lahat ng nag-message po sa atin doon. Okay? So muli maraming salamat po and God bless everyone.